date. You've been living with ignorance too long.
Please.
I want to impart some information because it's obviously coming back to you anyway, and I want to be the first. I want to be the very first.
As life fluctuates, prime ain't sleeping, butterflies wake. That's how I face for a human being. What do you mean? Well, the way the stern lines correspond with thoughts being dispersed from your mind. Are you thinking? I'm always thinking. Then you're not a human. You're a conscious being. And who might you be? Truly, I can't exactly tell you that. You see, I'm sort of a spell you cast. I'm here to give you this to take with you as you seek intelligence. A staff, what's this for? To guide you on your path. It'll take you to the answers to questions that you never asked. And its powers will ever last. But I must leave now. He began to walk away. I'm like, no, don't go yet. There's so much that I don't know yet. He stopped for a whole second, cast me a sideways glance. Then he vanished before I could advance. That was the past, this is the present. And reflection, I now know it was me. To answer my questions, I came to myself to give me guidance for the knowledge I seek and give encouragement to find it. My thoughts disperse from my mind, travel the size of atoms when they not combine, and reintegrated another time in a book of rhymes, moving away from the spine. Or perhaps years ago, written backwards, now it's the diamond's third eye. You ever see a bird flying? Wonder why, not why he's flying, but why he's flying at that specific moment in time. Where is he headed, and does he still have to decide? They just like us, and that they lead their own lives. Maybe he's going to his man's nest, or maybe he wants to transgress. Treat his brain like spandex and expand, stretch the limits of a bird's given nature of living, and go to a place that no bird's supposed to visit. You can also give into your curiosity, even if it's just periodically. It doesn't make a difference, cause once you did it, you can't say that you didn't. It'll always be there, in the back of your mind, sitting, waiting for you to access your imagination. You're trembling and shaking, but you can overcome that fear if you face it. You're scared because your life appears to be changing. It is, that's what happens. You must go astray from your older ways. Turn your back on your friends or go play. Do what you want, but you can't have it both ways. It's one or the other, and once you adjust your life structure, you can't influence others, not even your own brother. He ain't gonna change because you tell him to. Yes, he will. No, he won't. He has to do it of his own free will. You can teach, provoke him to think, but you have no control over the outcome that he will reach. You can hand him a feather, but he has to dip it in the ink. I must admit, the situation is usually bleak. As soon as you speak, cats go into defense mode and slam a door on you and your info. Like when the wind blows through a room with an open window, you have to improvise. The door can't close when the hinge broke. You can't treat your friends, foes, or your kinfolk like your kinfolk. They gonna take everything for a big joke. You gotta set them down, tell them shut up, listen, then you can go. When you finish, that's the end of the road. Leave them alone, they gonna do whatever they gonna do. After you talk to them for an hour or two, you can't stress it any more powerful. Now let's go back, like drowning in the fountain of youth. Back to you, have I reached you? Are you gonna change the way that you think, do? Let all that water run out of your brain like a sink, do? Or are you gonna sink to a lower level? Out of spite, cause you won't settle for anyone to tell you. Despite the treble in the vessel that nestles within your skull, I know it's hard. Why not choose to overcome a pebble before a stone wall when it's so tall? And that small rock requires no effort at all. You don't have to walk before you crawl. I don't expect you to come that far after this one song. It don't have to happen instantly, but that pinnacle should be reached eventually. Don't you find it odd that for the past 8 or 9 centuries, probably longer because I don't know my history, that human beings are considered lucky to live a century? How come we still using medicine to cure injuries? By now we should be able to do that type of thing mentally. We should be able to do everything mentally. That's probably what we was meant for since our race's infancy. We just living machines, only living because we make decisions independently. If you taught computers that they needed electricity to stay in activity and build them so they can reproduce on their own and thrive, make one of their goals to survive. They look at electricity as the food they need in order to stay alive, then they be alive. As far as they're concerned, the ones we use don't do much of this, and they carry germs, viruses that destroy documents and shut down entire units of central processing. The same thing goes on inside of men, but you stupid motherfuckers won't even open your minds a bit. That's why you never go to half of the places that I've been, cause you're determined to further your unconsciousness, never to return the opposite direction and step with your walking stick.